Hello everyone, welcome to Andy Visits. While jump scares have garnered a negative reputation over the years, a sudden jolt can be just enough to capitalize on building tension and serve as an effective method of grabbing the audience attention. So here we are discussing some of the best movies without any jump scares. Geralt's Game. Based on novel written by Stephen King, Geralt's Game is perfect for horror hounds with an aversion to jump scares, but who live for plausible terror. The film begins when Jesse and Geralt go to a remote house by a lake where they can share some intimate time together. After Jesse leaves food out of a stray dog, the couple moves to the bedroom with Geralt using a pair of handcuffs to secure Jesse's hand to the bedposts. Within a matter of moments, Geralt suffers a heart attack and lays unresponsive on the bedroom floor. Cuffed to the bedspots, Jessie is unable to help her husband or, as she quickly discovers, herself. The remainder of the film is devoted to Jessie terrifying to free herself from the handcuffs while simultaneously confronting her present and past traumas. Though the threat of starvation and dehydration looms over her, the drama builds as a stray dog returns even hungrier than before.
We only do this every 90 years.
Midsommar. Directed by Ari Aster, the creative mind behind Hereditary, Midsommar is a perfect film for horror lovers who hate jump scares. The film follows Dani, a young woman who has recently lost her parents in an unexpected accident. Dani's boyfriend Christian feels compelled to invite her along on a group vacation to a friend's hometown in a small Swedish village. Once the group arrives in Sweden, they are invited to partake in village festivities, but despite the friendly faces and flowery facade, an ominous undertone permeates the seemingly peaceful setting, and the curious guests unceremoniously trampled over the village's customs and traditions, things take a most sinister turn. Rosemary's Baby. Usually, the birth of a healthy, happy baby is a joyous event, but Rosemary's Baby turns what is supposed to be a celebration into a nightmarish occurrence. Shortly after moving into the new apartment, Guy and Rosemary starts planning for an addition to their family. While trying for a baby, Rosemary notices something a bit off with her nosy neighbors, Minnie and Roman. Aside from the chanting in the night, Minnie is just a bit too meddlesome, continually doting on Rosemary and poking around her home. But while Rosemary can handle the older woman's overly friendly demeanor, she begins to suspect something a bit more sinister is going on with Minnie and her husband. Despite Rosemary's desperation to be taken seriously, no one believes her suspicions. And once Rosemary becomes pregnant, she is determined to do whatever it takes to protect herself and her child. A Girl Walks Home Alone at Night. It is a Persian film about an unlikely romance between a young man named Arish and a mysterious woman. One fateful night, Arish stumbles across the woman while lost and is brought back to her apartment where they form a bond with one another. Unknown to Arish is the fact that the woman is actually a vampire who has no qualms about seducing and killing young men. The vampire is the woman referred to in the film's title, but she is not as helpless as the little might just suggest. She may be waking up home alone at night, but it is others who should be looking over their shoulders. The film shows the woman interacting with the people of Arish's Iranian hometown, examining different aspects of her nature as a vampire. The Black Coat's Daughter. The Black Coat's Daughter favors an atmospheric approach to horror rather than the action-packed take flavored by many similar titles in the genre. The film begins by following a lonely girl named Kat living at a religiously boarding school where she makes a rather unseemly friend. As just about everyone else has left for winter break, Kat becomes convinced that her parents have died, and she begins acting like she's been possessed, much to dismay of the nuns looking after her until her parents arrive. The film has been praised by critics for its atmospheric moodiness, lack of jump scares, and its evocating of raising dread.